Just minutes ago, a French prosecutor told CNN that the second black box has been found. We are expecting to hear from the German prosecutor at any moment now. So let's head immediately to CNN's Will Ripley. He's in Haltern, Germany with more. Hi, Will.
Hey, Carol. Yeah, that breaking information just coming in. And if you look behind me, you can see that the German prosecutor outside of the office here has gathered, and they are going to be speaking to reporters. We do have a camera over there, and we will bring you those breaking details at any moment. But we have now confirmed moments ago that the second black box, the flight data recorder for Germanwings Flight 9525, has been recovered. And this is important, Carol, because this will answer crucial technical questions in this investigation. The transcript of the cockpit voice recorder was leaked earlier. The flight data recorder will help investigators know exactly what was going on technically with the plane at the time of the crash. It will help them, for one, rule out that there was any sort of technical issue with the aircraft. And it will also perhaps confirm their suspicion that Andreas Lubitz may have been manually flying the aircraft towards the French Alps in those final moments. Now, also within the last hour or so, some new breaking details about that co-pilot, Andreas Lubitz. This is coming to us from a law enforcement source with close knowledge of this investigation. This source telling CNN that Lubitz was very afraid he would lose his pilot's license. And in fact, after suffering depression back in 2009, a severe episode, he relapsed late last year and was doctor shopping, essentially going from doctor to doctor, seeing as many as six of them, trying to get help for a vision problem, which was believed to be psychosomatic, meaning made worse by his mental state. He was given not fit to work notes by those doctors. Those doctors did not believe that he belonged in a cockpit. However, due to German privacy laws, they were not able to inform the airline directly. That was up to Lubitz. We know that he didn't do that and, in fact, tore up those notes because they were found in his apartment. We also know that he was prescribed heavy depression.
I'm going to interrupt you. This is Christoph Kompa, spokesman for the public prosecutor in Germany.
Press release of the prosecution. The prosecution, together with the police in Düsseldorf, have secured documents with data. We have secured a so-called tablet and analyzed it. Personal correspondence and search words show that the device was used by the co-pilot from 16th to 23rd of March is recorded on this device.
An mindestens einem Tag hat sich der Betreffende darüber hinaus über mehrere Minuten mit Suchbegriffen über Cockpit-Türen und deren Sicherheitsvorkehrungen
auseinandergesetzt. Bitte haben Sie Verständnis. There was some information about the cockpit doors.
Nicht bestätigen oder gar mitteilen werden.
We cannot confirm and infirm this because of the assessment of the analysis. The documents are comprehensive and we will not be able to inform you about this in the coming days. Thank you.
All right, a very short statement from the German prosecutor's office. Let's head back to Will Ripley and help me discern this. Suppose this prosecutor's or this spokesperson says they found a tablet, a device, and on this device was information taken from March 16th through the 21st. And somehow in there, and I couldn't quite get all of this, and maybe you could, that there was information on that tablet about cockpit doors and more.
Which, of course, Carol, is a huge potential lead in this investigation because if it turns out that Andreas Lubitz was researching ways to keep the cockpit door locked and ensure that his pilot could not get back in once locked out, then that would provide evidence that perhaps this was indeed a premeditated act of murder as opposed to the manslaughter investigation, which is underway right now. That's been a big question that we have been following ever since this crash. Was this a spur-of-the-moment action, or was it something that had been planned? In Lubitz's apartment, there was no evidence of any radical political views. There was no suicide note. Of course, he didn't tell anybody that we know of that he was planning this. But if he was doing research about cockpit doors and ways perhaps to stay locked inside, that would be a huge bombshell in this investigation. Of course, we don't have the answers. They're saying they won't be able to release that information. But we are on the ground working our sources to try to learn as much as we can, Carol. Was this premeditated? Was it spontaneous? We know it was tragic, but we need to find out exactly what he did, when, and why, as investigators try to do what they can. In fact, Germany here, they formed a task force. They're looking at everything to prevent this from ever happening again, Carol.